And the plot thickens. That's interesting. I'm not entirely sure what to make of it, and considering that we're only into day 29, I'm kind of curious to see how much more convoluted and, you know, tangled this whole thing gets. Alright. So, an unidentified vehicle struck and killed the young banker, John Patsy, then fled the scene, so we basically know who it is, but still. So we have the homicide. Oh, that's right, we solved that, and we need to go pick him up. Three armed robbers wearing masks entered the bank and demanded the manager open the safe. So we're going to send three and the SWAT team, just because whenever you're dealing with banks and money and guns, it never ends well. And then I should be able to hire someone new, but for some reason it's not letting me. Oh, the investigation has started. Wonderful. Alright, a young woman frightened to death just called from the trade union. A drunken factory worker broke into the building at the same man who yesterday visited the union, demanding a return of the money that was withheld from his salary over the past 6 years. The man is shouting and threatening to break through the service window. Go pick him up. The man is located in the city center where there's a lot of traffic and civilians. Block the exit with a police cruiser. Take a comfortable firing position at the main exit. Sneak up to the front window and peek inside the bank. Now we're gonna block exit. A woman's shouts can be heard from inside the bank. Wait until the robber exits, storm the building, get on the bullhorn. Yes. And the offender was caught. Good job, everyone. Alright, so that means we can now put detectives. Apparently he can't be. That's interesting. Okay. We'll just put a couple more there. And I think we're good. So unfortunately I can only send one more person. And I'm really hoping shit. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come back. There we go. We just received an alert from a jewelry store. Six armed men wearing masks entered the premises demanding all the cash and jewelry be placed in a large garbage bag. So we're gonna definitely send that and those guys and see if... There we go. Two, three. Plus SWAT team and the paddy wagon. If it's six armed guys, we're gonna need as many people as we can. That's too bad. Alright, what's this? During a production of My Sweet Juliet, the Zombie, actors in the performance were... Oh, buffeted by flying eggs thrown by someone from the audience. The assault was accompanied by shouts, "Shame, necrophilia, how dare you mock such a classic?" According to the elderly theater guard, the eggs were thrown by 10 young girls all dressed in white. Alright, I don't think this requires a huge amount of people. I think those two will be plenty. So, Let's see. Oh dear. Send two more, but I need to have at least one cop to handle something else. And I don't have that, and I still have a day before I can request anything more.
311A, 412A.
A call just came in from a girl who went with her friends to have a barbecue out by the sawmill. When the food was almost ready, a group of drunk students suddenly appeared claiming that it was their spot. A massive fight broke out. So there's no way anyone's gonna come back in time. Well, maybe those two might come back in time. Although they're kind of sucking today. Fuck! The reception at City Hall doesn't have enough protection. The manager urgently requests you send more officers. I can send you one, but you won't take just the one. So I have no choice but to refuse. Come on. There we go. So we are going to send two, but that's all I can send right now. I'm gonna get a call from the fucking mayor, aren't I, saying, who should be doing your job? I am doing my job, motherfucker. Maybe if you didn't call me over for stupid shit all the time. Ah. Maybe if you authorized more positions. Three armed thugs managed to rob the audience of a playhouse. Before the civilians realized what was happening, the criminals had already fled the scene. Until the last minute, everyone thought it was all part of the show. The cloakroom attendant says that the robbers left in a yellow school bus. I don't think this requires a huge amount of people. 311. Once again, I swear to God, anything that woman with the brown hair is on just fucking fails right today. I don't get it. Is she maybe tired? Is she tired? I haven't checked her. Looks like her energy level's all the way up. She's just sucking today. Okay. An eyewitness reported that a man drove up to the gas station, got out, and shot the guy behind the counter with an automatic rifle. And now he's just standing there, quickly filling up his gas tank. This dude is crazy. I agree. I'm gonna send all four cops that I have and just do without and hope for the best. Even late at night, finding the right bus wasn't too difficult. The criminals abandoned it in less than a mile from a suburban motel. Check the motel. The motel manager reports three men threatened me with a gun when I said we had no more rooms. I put them in a room we already rented, but they won't be happy when our guests return. Trying to trick the gunman. Who's there? You're in our room. I don't think that, because that's going to get them prepared with their guns. Open up police, or all civilians to return to their rooms, lock their doors, then begin the assault. Awesome! Alright, so I think we're doing okay, although I'm still waiting to hear back from the mayor telling me what a failure I am. But that's okay. That's alright. Oh, this is the hit and run. It's just three. Homicide. Are you fucking kidding me? Ooh, but we got automatic weapons. Ask the mafia to sell them. So, trying to figure out about how much money I should have. I'm thinking though I'll have more opportunities to earn money as we go through the game. But it kind of seems like I'm a little low.
Oh, Jack, you always come back so late.
What's wrong? Bad news?
Good news, Jack. Laura is ready.
Ready how? She's coming back? When?
Not that fast, Jack. Laura's ready to talk. But if she's ready to talk, she's getting ready to come back. You just need to find the right words. You can find the right words, right, Jack?
I'm not an idiot.
I didn't ask for this, Jack. It's the middle of the night, and I'm alone on an old farm, 40 minutes away from anywhere, sat on a creaky porch, and now I'm getting snapped at. I came here so you could personally promise me that you'll be able to find the right words. So let's try again. You can find the right words, right, Jack?
I can find the right words, Mrs. Markham.
That's good to hear. Tomorrow night at 3 o'clock at the Octopus Restaurant. You know it?
Yeah, but it's closed at night.
Oh, I've arranged for them to be open. Don't be late. But don't come too early either.
Mrs. Markham?
Yeah?
I should probably offer you some tea or something before you go.
Do you have any tea?
No.
Good night, Jack.
I hate his wife. If it were me, you know, just ask for a fucking divorce. Give her the divorce papers. If she wants to run off and have a fling, fine. That's her choice, but it's my choice not to put up with that shit. We don't have any kids. No, wait, I think he does have kids. He has three sons, doesn't he? Still, they're grown, so you don't really have to worry about it. Divorce her. Debbie's Cafe charged with health and safety violations. Red Cat rescues girl from rapist. Biannual report, more deaths than births in Freeburg. And no one's asking for the day off. Can we just... I kind of want to just declare him dead now, but okay. Well, I guess we haven't gotten his week's paycheck yet, so we'll get his paycheck and then we'll report him dead. And that's why I don't have... Oh my god, I'm so stupid. I forgot, and I'm like, why haven't I gotten approved from the city to get... to have another job open up? It's because I fucking chose to declare him dead, and now I'm reminding myself of why I just fucking report them dead. Because I hate being short-staffed more than anything. So, jobs... those are both kind of... No. Raise, detective. Let's ask for another raise. All right. Retiree Manny Versch called in a report of a fight between a little girl's father and a dog lover whose Rottweiler had frightened the child. While the men were busy settling matters, the dog was spotted running towards the amusement park. All right. I'm not going to send a bunch of my officers to collect a dog. It's amazing how, like, I chose to not report him dead, and then, like, I still managed to forget, you know, what that means. It seems... City Hall is the unhappy target of a spontaneous demonstration. Some 20 people have gathered in protest against the increased garbage tax. The protesters are behaving peacefully, but are demanding to speak with city officials. So we'll send, the paddy wagon, and they're peaceful, and it's only 20 of them, so two officers I think will be fine. Tiffany Lee, while visiting the local mall, encountered a hooded man who grabbed her expensive bag and bolted. She immediately called the police. "Isn't the mall safe anymore? That man must be in the building. Please hurry." So we'll send best and worst. Unlawfully. And everything was peaceful, so we're good. So, let's see.
Looks like we have a situation.
The offender attempted to escape the mall, but guards blocked the door. He turned and fled back inside, looking for another way out. Run after him. Order the man. No, you're gonna have to run after him. The offender ran into the skating rink, then slipped and fell on the ice. As he struggled to regain his footing, he pulled a knife from his pocket. Use pepper spray. Use pepper spray on him. It's better to just incapacitate them. Distanced non-lethal attacks, when possible, are probably the best option, I think, for us. So, a woman put up a tent in the park and is inviting everybody to come buy a new highly profitable currency, which will rise 10 times in value over the coming weeks. A long line has already formed and people are starting to push and curse each other. Alright, not in the park, ma'am. So what is 8 successful, 24 successful, she is a superstar. Alright, we'll send 3 more. So 30 successful and only 1 failed, 19 successful, 3 failed, 15 successful, 6 failed, 10 successful, 1 failed, 13 successful, 1 failed. What was his? 3 successful, 1 failed, and 1-1. He's been on the force for only 7 days, though, so I'll cut him some slack. Frank Conroy's wallet was stolen at the bus stop. He quickly noticed the loss and is hunting for the pickpocket with his friends. The group is blaming everyone in sight, and the situation is quickly escalating. The matter may soon come to blows. Yeah, let's go ahead and send someone. We'll send both of them to de-escalate the situation. And pray that... Okay, good. So they're coming back. And we have money! But we'll go ahead and bring it to the police station since it's not super valuable. And I hope I can report that guy dead soon, because not having the extra officer really fucking sucks. A man came to the hospital with a very large dog. The dog was on a leash and wearing its muzzle, but it was growling and jumping on the other patients. The duty nurse warned the man that it was against hospital policy to bring animals into the building, but the man just snarled at her and refused to listen. Well, only 1 cop, so we're of course going to send them. We'll send someone competent to do it, because we don't want that to escalate any more than it needs to. And yes, they got them. Alright, approximately 100 people have gathered in the park to protest the construction of a new casino near the cemetery. Soon after, a group of pickup trucks pulled up and several strong men climbed out. Without saying a word, they began to fight with the demonstrators. Oh shit. We'll send 3 plus the cops and the paddy wagon, because it's needed. Disorderly conduct, was arrested, and the officer was unharmed, so we're good there. The fight is in full swing, and some of the combatants are carrying weapons. Enter the fight and attempt to detain the hooligans. There's too many of them. That's a stupid decision. Surround the park and order everyone to calm down. Better than the first option, but I'm not entirely sure that's best. Shoot in the air in an effort to pacify the crowd. If you're going to start shooting stuff, it's just going to cause a hysteric response. There's too many people. Not everyone will get that. It was a police firing a weapon in a relatively safe manner to get everyone's attention. So, yay! That was simple enough.
412A in progress.
Alright, assault. A young DJ, upon exiting a store, ran into a strange-looking man wearing a black and red robe. First, the man knocked his energy drink from the DJ's hand and then told him of the merits of drinking human blood. That's lovely. His demeanor became threatening and he demanded money for protection from the forces of darkness. A fight between the two men erupted, during which the DJ suffered several bites. Oh, shit. The attacker then began to accost other passers-by, including a frightened group of teenagers, and then sunk his teeth into the shoulder of an elderly woman. Okay, yeah. This guy is batshit crazy. We need 2 highly competent officers on the scene to deal with this. Because what happens when you deal with crazy? You need as much help as you can possibly get. Oh, man. Don't you love... I mean... Of course you don't love dealing with it, but you have to admit, when someone tells you of dealing with, like, some exceptionally crazy bitch, or anyone, really, even if it's just a crazy kid, like, it makes a good story. You have to admit that. Alright, open the investigation, and we need 5 cards. We have 5 cards, so let's go ahead and see. Okay. Alright, so, let's go, yeah, so this one, no, okay, so, let's try... Okay, if those aren't working, then chances are I simply don't have the right cards. Which would make sense given that the first picture in the sequence has a completely different car from the one that's shown here. but it would still... No, we're just gonna leave it for now.